Yo, what's going on? It's the NOC, the Nerds of Color, and I'm your boy, Kuya P, a.k.a. the Babinka Boy, the Adobro, leader of the Hala Hala Homies in the Cine Gang Gang of the Nerds of Color's Show Pal Show, and today I have a knock exclusive for you all. I am really loving the new Netflix show, Sweet Tooth, that was adapted from the comic books by the amazing Jeff Lemire. If you haven't seen it yet, you need to check it out, but I'm going to show you real quick the trailer, and then we're going to have fun with one of the stars of the show, Aliza Villani. She plays Rani Singh. We're going to have a fun time talking all about the show and why you should check it out. So here we go. Sweet Tooth from Netflix. Here we go.
Once upon a time, bad people ruled the earth. They were greedy and self-destructive. So nature made everyone sick.
Excuse me? Are you a doctor?
And then a miracle happened. They called them hybrids. Your kind. It's your job to live a full life. But some bad people are still out there, Gus. If I hear a voice,
I will run.
If I see a human,
I will hide.
We have reason to believe that you are harboring an animal child.
Come here, little freak.
Thank you.
What's in Colorado?
I heard there's a safe place for kids like me.
If you go out there alone, they'll have your head by morning.
I'm not alone. I got you.
Guys like me aren't good for kids like you.
How do you know? Most people hate kids like me.
Rusty.
The Last Men have made it their mission to eliminate hybrids. But we've made it ours to protect them.
This new world is all about survival, no matter the cost.
What are you doing with him?
I did what I had to survive.
If there's anyone out there like me, I need to find them.
That little dude's got hope coming out of every pore.
But I won't cry for yesterday. There's an ordinary world.
Boom! There you go. The trailer for Sweet Tooth. It's on Netflix. You got to check it out. And right now, as you see, I have one of the stars of the show, Aliza Villani. She plays Rani Singh. Air horns.
Hey.
We're so excited. Hey. So much a pleasure to have you. Thank you for joining us. And thank you for repping. We kind of talked a little bit about that earlier. It's always good to see us shining and being on the screen, especially as Southeast Asians, you know. I come by by way of the Philippines, but I love it because we need our faces and we need that inspiration to see that we can achieve. And so I love it. And we're celebrating for you that you're out there doing it. And represent Canada too. All y'all Canadians are taking over. I've been doing so many Canadian interviews right now. It's like, I think I need to move up there. Cause like, where are all the acting jobs happening for me, you know, in the US?
No, Canadians are definitely making waves in the industry right now. And I'm loving every minute of it.
Heck yeah. You got to love it. So Aliza, can you tell us how this role came to be, how it came your way? Were you familiar at all when these sides came to you? Audition or
no, you know, I got the audition back in early 2019, and I hadn't heard of the comics before, but it was so cool to really read up on it. And because it was a fairly new character, I didn't actually need to go into Sweet Tooth for source material. So I actually went in just from the scene alone that they provided. And we actually shot the pilot back in June of 2019. So that's when I actually got into the comics and got to explore the world. But it was awesome because I got to really read the comics as someone who didn't have to focus on any other character. I really got to just dive into the world and the nitty gritty of it all, which was so cool to just read Jeff Lemire's work, because it's quite dark, which is not quite the direction that we were taking it when we shot the pilot.
I've heard, and I've seen, I think I told you earlier, I've seen the first three episodes. Different take from talking to other friends that were diehard comic fans, but an interesting take. They still are appreciating that change up, and to reach a wider audience, sometimes you have to do kind of subtle changes to it. So knowing as well that, and you just stated that your character wasn't in the comic book, it's sort of a new comic book new character within this universe and existing in this universe. I would have to say it probably feels good that you didn't have to have the weight of that, because, you know, when you come into a project that has such like an established continuity or just a way people are already seeing certain characters, that could be a bit of a weight. So how was that?
It was interesting because even Adil going in playing Dr. Singh, that is a huge character in the comics. So it's interesting that really our story in season one is expanding really on Singh's world before we even see him in the first edition of Sweet Tooth. So it was really cool because we really were establishing and expanding so much on their story together. And we had so much more room to kind of play, which was great. And I'm just excited to see kind of where they go from there, because the first season really sets it up in a great way for these two.
Heck yeah. And I love it. I love the relationship. And I think I saw elsewhere that being that you're playing, you know, two married characters, right before this, you were recently married. So you kind of were able to interpret that into your role. And I would assume because you're helping establish this character with your colleague who, like we said earlier, he kind of has the weight on him, whereas you didn't have it as much. You could kind of work together, help build this. Can you just tell me how that as an actor relationship, which you already kind of touched upon, but, you know, even further.
But I love it. It really... What was so great about it was their story is so rooted in love. It's never about the relationship falling apart. That's what I love about their storyline, is that their relationship is rock solid. And for someone who had just gotten married, that was something that I genuinely needed. I didn't need to be playing someone where their relationship is in crumbles. But really diving into these two characters that are really ride or die. And that was so much fun to play, even with, you know, Adil, with his family and us coming together. It was such a fun experience playing these two and playing it rooted in love, even though it does get quite intense and they have to make some very tricky decisions along the way.
I love it. I love it. And congratulations again, by the way. It's funny when you're in this, you know, when you're in this sphere of pop culture and, you know, and celebrity and status, people kind of know things about you, which is so different. Like I even in a small way, I get it. It's kind of odd, but I hope you don't mind that.
I'm still getting used to it, to be honest with you. I'm getting used to people all of a sudden knowing little details about my personal life.
So thank you for being cordial with that. But yeah, doing my homework. I wouldn't be a good host if I didn't do my homework.
Exactly. You're just doing it.
So diving into this, this world and that came for the comics, and you said like you got into the graphic novels and read up a little bit more. It's different in tone. Can you just tell us when you nailed the character, you got the audition, you're in here, you're now part of this cast. What was it when you got involved that you wanted to bring to the character that might not have translated from the script that you kind of wanted to bring to it and also continue to bring to it, hopefully, you know, if we get further seasons?
Yeah. Well, one thing that Adil Akhtar actually did was he brought so much lightness to his character, and that really bonded the two of us and our characters, that there was so much fun and play. And given that their storyline is so dark and is a little bit closer to actually the tone of the graphic novel, that we were able to find lighthearted moments where you actually got to see why these two characters are so in love and married and happily married. So that was actually something that I got from Adil, is seeing how he was able to pick up on lighthearted moments, and we were able to play off of that with one another. I think that's what really was fun, even in collaborating on creating the wardrobe for these characters, which is something I loved with Ronnie. Our head of wardrobe, Amanda Neal, was fantastic, even in just the subtle details, because we do have two South Asian performers playing South Asian characters. And I loved that we had the opportunity to bring subtle elements without needing to acknowledge it in the script at all, that they were just in the background. And if you're from that culture or from that community, you'll recognize those details.
Yes, yes. So true. So true. And on that, and we kind of spoke on this as well about representation. Like I said, I love that you're shining for us as Southeast Asians and representing. And that's what we talk about a lot. Here at the Nerds of Color. That's what we're all about. We're the Nerds of Color. Can we talk about representation within, well, specifically in Sweet Tooth? And one of the things I love about the show, with you there representing, with, I'm going to mess up the character's name again, but with Gus.
Geppert.
Geppert. And the gentleman's name?
Nonzo.
Anonzo, that who plays an amazing role. The character was originally white, but translated to African-American. And yeah, so we have you, we have him and some other characters involved on the show of color. One of the things, it's a thing of brilliance that I love, because in most times and in most shows, we really, you know, let's be honest, there's not a lot of representation. And so that's why we talk about it with the Nerds of Color and then just in all forms of media. So one of the things I do love with kind of like these quote unquote post-apocalyptic shows, it kind of puts us all, I think, on like the same line in a way, in regards to it erases that racism, but it's still there, which you kind of see that in the show. But then in a way, I think it brings a humanity back. Do you feel that in the same way in how representation speaks within these kind of bodies of work, and as well as with what we see with Gus and how just, we talking about being different and, you know, there's all these different metaphors, you know, can you speak in that regard?
Yeah, absolutely. What I loved that Sweet Tooth provides as just a story in general is the concept of hybrids and how the human civilization feels towards hybrids. And that varying, I think, speaks to a lot of what goes on in our already like day-to-day society of how we treat something that's different or that we don't understand, and how important knowledge and love and connection really is. And that's what this show is all about. Even when you have so many characters of color, the fact that that's not the point of the plot, I think, is what speaks to how we're moving forward in diversity. That while that's so important to have, I think it's so great that Sweet Tooth is exploring these characters, and it's about the character and their journey, not necessarily how the color of their skin affects their story. And I think that's just an added layer to storytelling and telling diverse stories. And so I'm really proud to be a part of a show that does that and does it so well. And you really see that even on set, behind the camera. You feel that in a family, that really it is an all even playing field, and everyone's just there to tell a beautiful story about belonging and healing and connecting. And that goes across every single community, no matter where we are in the world.
Exactly. I love it. You exactly what I was trying to get across, and you said it, because we get these stereotypes a lot, or at least that's what I've gotten. I like as an actor of getting a bunch of the thug roles when I just be myself. And I'm very celebratory of my people and my culture and my pride and the things that we do. I want that represented on the screen, but then sometimes I just want to just be, you know, and that's what you can be in certain shows like this. And I love it. And you guys are amazing. You can just shine for the beauty of who you are as just as a person, as a soul. And so I love it. Speaking of family, and I noticed and have seen again doing my homework that was a big thing for you and then for this whole crew and cast of building this family and this working relationship, because you guys also were filming this during the pandemic. How was that? I can't imagine. I was low during, I didn't want to do anything because it felt like the end of the world. I just can't even imagine working, but I saw that you did, everyone took great precautions. They took care of you, but can you speak on that?
Yeah, I think what was the most interesting aspect is that we all went into New Zealand around August of 2020, and we were coming from many different parts of the world. You had people from the UK, from the US, from Canada, from South Africa, from Australia, and then some locals from New Zealand. And so you saw groups of people that had completely different experiences for the first 6 months of the pandemic, now all coming into this space and this beautiful country of New Zealand to tell a story about the aftermath of this big crumble, which is the result of the pandemic.
Yeah.
So it was very interesting considering we shot the pilot before this even happened of 2020, and then going into it and having all of us come together and have different experiences, it became very important for us to support one another, to show how much we were there for one another and could connect because we had all been isolated in various ways for so long. And so I think making that concrete effort to show that much love really translated into the story and created really lifelong relationships and friendships with not only the cast, but the production crew and just the whole team that created this series.
Oh yeah, I love that. Because I miss some of my crew folks that I've worked with, but it's been so long and all of that. You build a whole bond because everybody's there to put out an amazing product and make everybody shine together. It's a team effort. I love it. I noticed on another interview that I saw doing my homework again, you shout out to Dania Ramirez, who you yes. met on a plane and all that. I love her.
She is amazing. Yeah. She is the adventurer. She just captures that, which is so great. Her and I had a few adventures together and we didn't get a chance to work together. But what was so great is even after her and I would wrap on particular days, we would go have dinners together. We got to know one another. So what was so great is even though we have very separate storylines with different groups of cast members, that didn't matter. We all made a very big effort to spend as much time with one another as we possibly could. But yes, Dania and I were quarantine buddies. We were in different floors and we were just messaging each other, you know, meditating in the morning together. So it was great just meeting someone that way too and having that connection right off the bat before we started filming.
I love it. I thought that was so cute. That was a cute story there. So shout out to Dania. I just love her. Her work. So you, as you stated, because there's all these different storylines that are occurring, and so you don't get to meet and really interact with a lot of the different teams that, you know, are on this project. How different was that for you? Trying to figure out, I guess, the rest of the storylines because, you know, you have your sides for your scripts. How does all this tapestry fit with everything that you've kind of been presented? And because you don't really get to know all of that.
Yeah. And I think the same storyline is a little bit darker than the other two. And we don't necessarily have, the hybrids you see in the beginning, like that's something that eventually starts blending as you watch the season. So we found ourselves kind of starting out with very separate storylines. And then as the season progressed, as we started filming and slowly characters started overlapping, we actually got to see it collectively shape into what will be an incredible story should we get to continue telling it. Because it really, I won't reveal too much, but the end of the season, it really sets it up for a really beautiful journey.
Yeah, I can't wait. I'm only on episode 3. I think I told you a little bit earlier. I saw your finger twitching. And so I'm not going to tell what that is and stuff because I'm still trying to understand what's going on. I think I need to rewatch again because I'm like, you know, when you're busy and everything, you don't always pick up all the little details. But I'm nervous for you. I'm nervous for you. I don't know really what's happening because I was seeing that happen to other characters and I knew what was going to happen with those characters because of that. So I'm nervous for your character, Ronnie, but I'm sure you're going to be okay. My hopes.
Keep watching. That's all I have to say. Keep watching. You think episode 3 is hard.
Oh, man.
Just wait.
I love it. Can you, as this story has been occurring and working with everybody and your wraps now, we're hoping, you know, for season 2 and that the feedback is positive. Do you know, is there anything you can tell us about what is, has there been any talk yet Or is it just still kind of waiting to hear, you know, more of the feedback since it just recently launched?
Yeah. So because it just recently launched, we're all just excited to be sharing the story with everyone. So we're hoping for good news. But right now it is just a lot of love from the cast and the team that we're all just sharing and excited that everyone gets to finally see what's been in the works for, you know, a couple of years for us, but in the works for years for a lot of the production team as well and Team Downey.
Awesome. And yeah, I can't wait. I want more, even though I know I still have more that, lucky for me, because I didn't binge it all in one scoop. I still have some more episodes I can enjoy. Are there any other projects that you have in the works that we can talk on and maybe also highlight as well? Because you've been in the game for a bit, I see.
Yeah, nothing that I could talk about right now. Really, it's so funny how the world of television has changed, because there's all these beautiful things in the works and then you have to just hold it in and wait until you can share the big news. So hopefully we'll have something to share soon.
All right. Well, then what I would like to do is if we can share your socials and ways that new fans can check you out that are watching this. Can we throw some of those out there so your fans can check you out and hit you up?
You can find me on Instagram or on Twitter at Aliza Villani, and I will be there sharing all things Sweet Tooth.
Awesome. Aliza. I knew I was going to mess it up at some point. I'm so terrible with names.
You got it. You were so close.
Aliza, this is truly a pleasure. I want to throw more at you, but I don't want to spoil questions because I still have more to watch. So I'll probably like maybe, you know, Aliza, hey, episode 7, what? Why? I don't know. I'm just throwing that out. Like I said, I'm only on episode 3 because I think
Let's
there's about 8 episodes
five.
Right now.
Episode five.
I've something to look forward to. Okay. All right. So, okay. I might be texting you episode 5. What happened? Why?
Aliza, exactly. Those exact words.
Truly a pleasure. Again, make sure you follow Aliza. I will have her links and everything in the description below. Yeah, this has been so much fun. Sweet Tooth, y'all. Check it out. Aliza Villani, Kuyapi, the Nerds of Color. We appreciate y'all as always. This has been another Knock exclusive. We're out of here.
Here, who plays Ronnie Singh on Sweet Tooth. Check me out on Nerds of Color, where we'll talk about all things Sweet Tooth. Hi, everyone. This is Aliza Villani from Sweet Tooth. And being a nerd of color for me means that anyone can explore this incredible, fantastical world of our imagination. So be sure to check out Nerds of Color, because I'm one too.